Hi viewers, today we have to learn how we can find the decimal form of a fractional number without doing actual division. Without doing actual division, we can find the decimal form of a fractional number which is in the form of p by q. Okay, let us learn that. Before that, I am asking you, if you not subscribe still now my channel, please subscribe my channel and click on the bell symbol to get up to date. Okay, thank you. And I'm going to this topic now. What is our topic? Finding decimal form of a fractional number which is in the form of p by q without doing actual division. Okay, I'm taking one example, that is 35/50. Okay, we can find decimal form of this fractional number 35/50 by dividing 35/50. It takes more much time. Okay, and also we are using another method now. That is, just we have to write. First, we have to simplify this number. After simplifying, you see here 5, 1 5, 5 0 0 0, and 5 7 0. It is 7/10. Okay, this is the first step, simplifying the fractional number. The second step, next step, just we have to write the denominator in its powers of prime factors. Powers of prime factors. That is actually 10 is equal to 2 into 5 prime factorization. That is powers of prime factors is 2 to the power of 1 and 5 to the power of 1. That means 2 to the power of 1 into 5 to the power of 1. Okay. Now the denominator is in the form of 2 to the power of m into 5 to the power of m, where powers are equal. Okay. And where m belongs to z plus positive integers. Okay, so here when we got the powers of 2 and 5 are equal, then what is the power here? 1. Okay, so directly we can write that 7/2 × 5, 10 to the power of 1. Okay, then it is equal to, this is equal to 0.7. Of course, we can write here directly 7/10 is equal to 0.7 only. But in another examples, to understand other examples, we have to do these steps. Okay. Let us take one more example, that is 21/25. 21/25. It is in the simplest form, simplified form. Okay. And now you see 21/25, if you write in its powers of prime factors, we can get 5 to the power of 2. Now you see here the denominator is not in the form of 2 to the power of m into 5 to the power of m. So what we can do? We should change the denominator in the form of into the form of 2 to the power of m, 5 to the power of m. Here actually 5 to the power of 2 there. That's why we need more 2 to the power of 2 in the denominator. That's why we multiply 2 to the power of 2 by 2 to the power of 2. It is equal to 21 × 4. 2 to the power of 2 is equal to 4. And divided by this 2 to the power of 2 into 5 to the power of 2. Okay. And next two. This one you see. 21 × 4. 4 × 4. And 4 to the 8. Divided by 2 to the power of 2 into 5 to the power of 2. It is in the form of 2 to the power of m, 5 to the power of m. That's why this one is equal to 10 to the power of 2. 10 to the power of 2. So here 10 to the power, the power is 2. That's why the decimal point will come before 2 digits of the numerator. So before 2 digits means 4, 8, and here 5 will come. And 8 before there is no digits. That's why you should keep 0. That's why 21/25 is equal to 0.84 is the answer. Okay, so we found. the decimal form of a fractional number without doing actual division. Let us take one more example, that is 7 by 8. Third example, 7 by 8. So once we have to observe whether it is in the simplified form or not. Yes, it is simplified form. 7 by 8 is the in its simplified form. So 7 by next step, this 8, the denominator should write in the in its powers of prime factorization. That means 2 to the power of 3 we can get. Okay, to get the denominator in the form of 2 to the power of m, pi to the power of m, we need to multiply by pi to the power of 3 by pi to the power of 3. It is equal to 7 into pi to the power of 3 is equal to 125 divided by 2 to the power of 3 into pi to the power of 3. And in the next step, 7 into this 125 we should do. 7 pi is a 35, 7 2 is a 14 plus 3, 17. Our carry 7 1 is 7 plus 1, 8 divided by 2 to the power of 3 into pi to the power of 3 is equal to 10 to the power of 3 we can write. So it is equal to the power of 10, the power is 3. So its answer is 3 digits before point, 1, 2, 3 digits before point will come here, point 8, 7, 5. So this is the answer. Okay, let us take one more example. Fourth example. Okay, I'm going to take one more example now. 7218 divided by 3 to the power of 2 into 5 to the power of 2. 3 to the power of 2 into 5 to the power of 2. Now, first what we have to observe whether the given fraction is in its simplified form or not. You see in the denominator 3 to the power of 2 into 5 to the power of 2. Actually, we need to change the denominator into 2 to the power of m into 5 to the power of m. But how we can change here 3 to the power of 2 also there in the denominator. But before that, first we have to observe whether it is in its simplified form or not. You see here 3 is a factor. 3 into 3. 3 to the power of 2 means 3 into 3. Now you see numerator 7 plus 2, 9 plus 1, 10 plus 18 is multiple of 3. That's why the numerator is also divisible by 3. So we can cancel by, that means we can divide numerator and denominator by 3 table. Okay, 3 1 is 3, 3 2 is 6, and 3 4 is 12, and 3 0 is 0, and 3 6 is 18. And here 1 3 get cancelled. And again one more 3 1 is 3, 3 8 is 24, and it is 0, and it is 3 2 is 6 get cancelled. So we can get 8 0 2 by 5 to the power of 2 only. So we need to change the denominator in the form of 2 to the power of m, 5 to the power of m. So we multiply with 2 to the power of 2 by 3 to the power of 2. So it is equal to 8 0 2 into 2 to the power of 2 is equal to 4 divided by 5 to the power of 2 into 2 to the power of 2. We can write 2 to the power of 2 into 5 to the power of 2. It is equal to, we multiply this numerator first. 4 to the 8, 4 0 0 and 4 8 are 32 divided by 2 to the power of 2 into 5 to the power of 2. We can write as 10 to the power of 2. So the power is 2, that is why the decimal point will come before 2 digits. 1, 2 digits. So point will come here. 32.08 is the answer. So this is the very important topic in 10th standard. So thank you very much.